recognize the member for Vancouver, Point Grey.
Honourable Speaker, 8 meetings, 4 technical reports, including an 88-page technical report on accessing these venues. The minister continues to make incorrect statements about the state of negotiations between PavCo and the City of Vancouver. Now, at the time he was telling the media these incorrect statements, he was under fire for heading a ministry where a senior staffer was under RCMP investigation for his role in the triple delete scandal. Not only that, Honourable Speaker, the minister was out telling the media how proud he was that he triple deletes his own email records. Now, the evidence shows that the minister has simply made up a controversy involving PavCo in the City of Vancouver, and clearly he's doing so to conceal his change the channel on his own involvement in the triple delete scandal and the scandal of his ministry being under RCMP investigation. Will he apologize to the hardworking bureaucrats at the City of Vancouver?
Members. Members. Please continue.
Honourable Speaker, there were many people involved in these meetings. Many thoughtful people prepared these technical reports. They did so carefully to protect the interests of people across the Lower Mainland. Will the minister apologize to those people who worked so hard for trying to change the channel at their expense?
Minister of Transportation and Infrastructure.
Well, thank you very much, Honourable Speaker. Look, as I said earlier, we don't control the timing of council decisions that are taken by the City of Vancouver. The City of Vancouver received a letter from PavCo several days before council took their final decision, outlining a number of concerns that PavCo believed to that point had not been adequately considered by the City of Vancouver. And I quote, Honourable Speaker, from the letter dated October 19th from PavCo to the Mayor and Council in Vancouver, among the key issues impacting PavCo are maintaining acceptable operating and event access for BC Place and the new Vancouver Urban Resort, residential development on Area 10C, soil remediation, design of the relocated Georgia Viaduct ramp and construction of parking beneath, First Nations consultation, Pacific Boulevard and other street designs, and traffic planning. In addition to that, there are some other issues that we want to make sure are also part of the consideration for moving forward. I have said several times, I will say again, we are committed to sitting down with the City of Vancouver and having these technical discussions so that we get this project right.